Oh, I do.
It's time to discover you. I'm bringing awareness to what God has for you and how you walk out any issue in your life. Each week, I will connect you to a life filled with purpose and how that purpose will be connected by God, requiring tips, tools, and resources on how you can encourage yourself. So now, I face and I have
good evening, good evening, good evening, everyone. My name is Shonda Nicole Gore, and I am a Lensoffaith. Tonight on the show, I have none other than Miss Parker.
Yes, God.
For y'all that don't know, Miss Parker has been praising the Lord since I've known her, and I'm sure she's been doing it her entire life.
Yes,
I saw this fabulous woman of God on the internet, on Facebook one day, just scrolling through, and I was like, who is this? And then I immediately just started tuning into her electrifying spirit, just watching what she was doing, and she was doing nothing but praising God, dancing and singing. And I started seeing everybody tuning in, and I said, oh my God, I have to find out who this woman is and connect with her. And I just want to dance with her one good time. My God, from Zion. Hallelujah. So, Ms. Parker, tell everybody who you are and where you're from.
My name is Andrea Paulette Parker, and the reason why I put an emphasis on Paulette, growing up, that's what they called me, was Paulette. And I had a radio show, and it was called the Paulette Parker Show. So Paulette actually is my favorite name. I love to be called Paulette. I am from Los Angeles, California, born and raised in South Central. I'm just a regular old down-home girl that loves the Lord. So that's who I am.
Hallelujah, God. Yes. My goodness. I didn't even realize you were all the way in Los Angeles.
I'm in Riverside now, but I was born and raised in L.A. So now I live in a suburb. I live out, I live east from Los Angeles. Not too far, because my kids are that way.
Mm-hmm. My goodness. My goodness. So I just want to ask you this question. You know, what made you decide to just be sold out for God?
You know what? If I'm honest, I had a praying grandmother.
Come on now.
And my grandmother lived to be 94 years old. And my grandmother didn't miss church. My grandmother didn't get up unless she prayed for you. If your finger was cut, my grandmother was going to pray for you. My grandmother was going to encourage you. Now, I had a mom. She went to church as well. And we all were together. But it was just something about that praying grandmother.
Mm.
And as I just sat up under her, literally sitting at her feet, I understood the importance of just being connected to Jesus, being connected to God. Because see, when we didn't have anything, we knew we had Jesus. When we can call Jesus for anything. And so that's where I learned it from, my grandmother. Because I had a praying grandmother.
Amen. I have a praying grandmother too. She's 99. She's still alive. And glory, all the honor and all the praise for my grandmother. Amen. I absolutely know exactly what you're talking about when you talk about that praying grandmother. And those prayers helped us through. You
well,
know,
I'm still
silly mistakes, the decisions we was making. Yes. Boy, my grandma need knee pads right about now for all the time she's been down on her knees praying for me. So I know the meaning of that praying grandmother.
Nothing like a praying grandmother. Nothing. Look, no, I can't be still.
Amen. So listen, you're on the Encourage Yourself series with Lensoffaith. Tell everyone how you encourage yourself to become the best you.
You know what? And this is the God's honest truth. There are days when I don't have it, but I can look to the hills. My house faces the west and the mountains are at the east. And that is how I encourage myself, because there are days when I just don't know what to do and how to do. And I just go to the word of God, and it's never, ever, ever failed me. But if you want to know the truth, I just go to the word of God. Lord, I'm in trouble. Lord, this is what I did. And you know what I love about the word of God? Everything I need is right in that book.
Amen.
Right in that book. That's how I
feel. Right in that book.
Mm-hmm.
Right in that book.
That's how I stay encouraged.
Well, listen, I gotta hit the audience with some dancing right now. So
okay, I'm gonna
play this song, and look, we just gonna let the Lord have his way on tonight.
Well, go right ahead. I'm gonna put my phone down. Can y'all see me? Because it's sunny out here, but look, I don't even hear no music, and I'm ready to go.
Come on, I got a good one for you.
All right, I'm listening.
Come on, Paulette.
Look, I'm already moving, and I can't hear nothing.
Come on, Wally.
My neighbors probably think I'm crazy because I'm so serious on the court. All right, Jesus.
Hallelujah, God. Woo! Glory to God. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Lord. Thank you, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for this day, oh God, a day we've never seen before, oh God. Father God, I just ask right now that you strengthen Paulette, Father God. Allow her to rise every morning to do your will, Father God. Father God, I just ask that you continue to pour into Paulette, oh God, because she is blessing the masses. Father God, bless her with more. Give her exceedingly and abundantly above all she can ask or think, Father God. Father, we ask that you pour down on her right now, Father God. Touch her right now. Touch her feet, oh God. Touch her legs, oh God. Touch her soul, oh God. Touch her mind, oh God. Father God, give her an increase in people to help her, oh God. Show up. You can show out, oh God, on that porch, Father God, every single morning. Oh God, we give you all the glory,
all the praise,
all the honor, and all the praise. Hallelujah, oh God. I thank you, Lord. In Jesus' almighty name, I pray. Amen. Woo, Jesus. On fire. On fire. On fire. On fire.
Hallelujah, Lord. Oh, glory. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. My God from Zion. Woo, Jesus. So, Paulette, tell the listening audience, the journey that took you to the porch.
Oh, I'm so happy you asked this question. So, you know, as I said, I had a radio show. And the radio show moved to Texas. Mm-hmm. And they wanted us to download something and do something. But I'm not real tech savvy. So it was just an excuse for me not to be on the show. I'm like, well, I don't know what I'm doing, so I can't do it. So I started walking, and I walked. Most people, I walk to talk to God, and I'm so serious. Because when I walk, I can hear God clearly. So I would get up and go down like a mile, and I could hear God tell me to get on the porch. He didn't literally say the porch. He just said, I need you to get back to opening your mouth. So I heard him. Sure, I did. I ain't go nowhere near a microphone. I didn't go nowhere near Facebook. If I tell God I was being disobedient, you better listen to me. I was being disobedient. So as I would come back home, I'd sit on the porch, and the porch looked different than this. I said it was a smaller setup, and I sat on the porch, and God would just talk to me, and I could hear him, just like I could just hear him. You know how, you know when the Lord is speaking to your heart. I could hear him. Wouldn't do nothing. He would tell me, I need you to open your mouth. I could hear God, wouldn't do it. I have this lady, a prayer partner. Her name is Sandra. And Sandra called me one day. Sandra called me and Gloria. I had two. And Sandra said, girl, I don't know why God done what. He woke me up to tell me to tell you, you need to get up and get on Facebook. He said, he don't care if you say two words, you better get up and get on Facebook.
Amen.
But you know I didn't get up and get on Facebook. I would not do it. I made every excuse. Lord, they gonna think I'm crazy. Lord, I don't know what I'm gonna say. I can't do it. Then I had this cousin, Gloria, and she's over in the background. Always, she's been telling me for years, girl, God got something big for you. You got stuff God needs you to do. I'm like, I promise you, I wouldn't do it. This one last time I was walking, and I heard God tell me, you got to open your mouth, and if you don't, I'm going to go get somebody else. Girl, you should have seen me running over here. And I couldn't get to the porch. I had to get to the, connect to the Wi-Fi. And I got to the Wi-Fi, and I just started running my mouth. And so as I started running my mouth, the people started coming in. And I didn't have any music in the background, have anything. All I had was me and my big old mouth. But I had Jesus, and he was enough. He opened it. He was going to fill it. So I started opening my mouth. And I would get back every day. I was going to come back. I was determined. I was going to listen. Because I could see God. I could feel God. And then I started playing music. And I just love to dance, always have. So, you know, I can't be still. I'm having a hard time sitting on the porch right now. So I had to just, I've been moving ever since. And I just want to praise God. I just want to give God the glory. Because see, God has brought me from a mighty long way.
Hey, yeah, shit. Come on. Come on.
But I've been through some things. And if I tell you, God has rescued me. God has been my very present help in my time of trouble.
Hallelujah.
So I have to be on the porch. I can hardly sleep sometimes wondering, Lord, can I go on the porch right now? I'm so grateful to God that he would choose me and allow me to stand on this on this platform.
Amen.
I thank God for Facebook too.
Amen. Amen. Well, you know, as a woman of God, I'm sure you've been through many trials, many tribulations. How do you encourage yourself through some of the toughest days as you even encounter your family members, your friends, and people that know you from the general public? Tell us about that.
Let me tell you guys a story that I'm a storyteller, and I'm a storyteller based on my life is an open book. And the reason why I use it as an open book, I guess that's why God would use me, because there's nothing you can say to me that would hurt my feelings or embarrass me. So when it comes to God, if he can use my story for his glory, I'm the girl. If you want to take my mess and use it as a message, I'm the girl. But let me tell you guys this story. So I have 14 children. And my oldest daughter and my number 12 daughter, they can't see eye to eye. And when they're good, but when they're bad, Lord Jesus, it's a tornado. And in the process of God telling me to get on the porch and opening my mouth, they were going at it. And I'm not a mother that has a favorite child.
If, right. You know,
they are my favorite. It depends on who's in front of me at the time. And boy, this particular time, it was just one of those, oh, it was just a blow up. And it hurt my soul. And I didn't, you know, you can't go lick that one's wound without licking the other one's wound, if you know what I'm saying. And in the midst of this is when God is saying, get on the porch, get on the porch. I'm like, get on the porch, talk to the people, God. What about I'm going through? But I realized that when I'm going through, it's because God is using me for a testimony. So that's how I get on. That's how it happens. I don't allow the outside stuff to hold me. Does that make sense? Does this make sense what I'm saying? Okay.
Absolutely. Okay. Absolutely. And, you know, a lot of people ask me, why did I start Lensoffaith? Who is Lensoffaith? Why am I a Lensoffaith? And I simply tell them that I heard the voice of the Lord.
See?
And when I obeyed the voice of the Lord, he started revealing things to me on what to do, when to do it, how to do it, who to impact. It was almost like boom, 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 boom. He laid it all out because I was listening. I had an ear for the Lord. And so I had to be obedient to the voice of the Lord on my life so that I can impact his kingdom. It's all for God to get the glory. It has nothing to do with me getting the glory, but it's all about God getting the glory. See, God will use us with our brokenness, with our mess, with our messed up ways, all of that. Because he says, I'll take you as you are. I just ask you to repent of your sins and say, Father, use me. Tell him you're ready. If you're ready, surrender it all to God today. And say, Lord, have your way. Father, forgive me for my sins. Yes. Forgive me for I have sinned against you. Jeez. God is waiting on us. We always quick to say, Lord, we waiting on you. We waiting
you
on
better.
You. So God is waiting for us.
Yes, yes, yes. Faith without works is dead. If you don't move, I can't use you because you're sick.
Amen.
I was talking to one of the ladies that there's three of us. It's Vicky, Pat, and myself. And people sit around and say, we waiting on you, Lord. But he's waiting on you. He needs y'all to do something. Move. You got to move. Just move. And if you move, he's going to tell you, okay, you're going down to the corner. Now make a right. You just got to be a willing vessel. You just have to get up and move.
Amen. Now, you know, I read through your bio, but even before I read your bio, this word came up to me about you, and it was unction. Immediately when I saw you, the word unction came to my spirit. And so I want you to tell the listening audience what unction means to you and how powerful that unction really is.
Okay, I told you I'm a girl of a story.
Amen.
So I told you guys I had 14 kids. My first six kids was by a husband that really wasn't a nice man. I loved him, but he didn't love me. I had to really come to grips with that. So when I left him, I learned to sit and read the word of God and pray for real. Not that other church. You know that church stuff where we sitting in church and we just in church because mom and them went to church.
Yeah.
I had to really learn what the depending on God was. And as I was sitting there in this horrible place that I was living in with my six, well, I had five babies. I was pregnant with the sixth child. And I was in this place. And God said to me, he said, I need you to get up. And this sounds so crazy. He said, I need you to get up and go to this gas station. Now, who tells you to go to the gas station and you saying, what I'm going to the gas station for? That's what an unction is. An unction is when the Holy Spirit says, do something, you need to be doing it. The Holy Spirit said, get up, go to this gas station. So I'm like, well, what am I going to do? But when you get up and you move, see, I got up, went to the gas station. I get to the gas station. I'm like, well, I'm here, Lord. What you want me to do? He said, go to the window. I go to the window and I tell the man. And I say to the man, I said, look, because I knew who owned this gas station, but I didn't know the person. I knew of her. So I'm at the gas station, and I say to the man, I said, look, I'm only here because God said I had to be at this gas station. I said, but is Vicky around? He said, you know, Vicky don't never come to this gas station. He said, but guess what? I said, what? He said, she on the phone. Bulletproof glass and all. He stuck the, because the phone was attached to a wire. Y'all know back in the day, he stuck the phone up under the bulletproof glass, and I spoke to Vicky. Unction means when the Holy Spirit says move, get up and move.
Hey!
You're gonna see me standing up under the tree. That's what unction means to me. When the Holy Spirit says move, I get up and I move.
Amen. My God. My God. Woo, my God. You talking good right there. As my bishop says, you talking good right there. My goodness, on fire. I'ma see what you got to this song right here, because we're getting ready to get up again now, Paulette. We getting ready to get up again now.
Some lemonade. I'm ready to go. What we doing? What are we doing?
Come on. Come on. Yay!
I can't hear it good enough. Y'all need some music in my soul. See, it's like fire set up in my bones. My bones move. My hands move. My feet move.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Thank you.
You've been so good.
Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. For
too confining for me. Woo, Jesus. Woo, glory. of Jesus.
Hey! Woo! Come on, Paulette!
Y'all, I got my wings!
Woo! Thank you, Lord. Woo! Hallelujah. Glory be to the Most High God.
Yes,
hallelujah. Woo! Get it, Paulette. And so I put in the comments earlier that if anyone is led by God to sow a seed, sow that seed. And someone just sowed a seed, and this seed is going to Paulette.
Oh,
Paulette.
Thank you.
We're going to bless you with that seed that just came in.
Thank you, Jesus.
And so,
hallelujah, Lord.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Oh, Jesus.
Hallelujah. This is good ground that someone just sold into, and they asked not to be identified. And so glory be to the Most High God. Thank you, Lord, for someone being obedient to be led by the Spirit. That very seed that was just sown is going to Miss Paulette. Woo! Hallelujah.
Let me say something real quick, if you don't mind.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
My phone almost died. It always almost dies every day. And this lady, she said to me, you need some kind of charger. So she called me and said, what's your address? I'm going to send you this charger. And as she's talking to me, she says, baby, you have no idea what God has for you. She said, you don't understand the seed that God is going to sow into your life because of your obedience. And for you to turn around. It was at 9 o'clock my time this morning when I was talking to her. And for God to show up that fast, you better come on with it, y'all. Y'all better know that my God, the God that I serve, is real. Oh, hallelujah, Lord. She talked to me, and she just sowed into my life. She just talked to me, and she prayed for me, and she told me, baby, it's your obedience. And because of your obedience, God is going to reward you. And I did not come on here expecting anything but to be obedient to what God would have me to do. And for you to sow a seed into my life, all I can say is thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Glory to your name. Hallelujah, Lord. We honor you this afternoon. Yes. I worship you. I magnify you. Thank you, Jesus. Woo! Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Oh. God is not He reigns forever and ever. Come on. God is an awesome God. Yes, He is. My God.
Oh, my God. I'm done.
Woo, Jesus.
I don't understand when God turns and moves that fast. Woo, Jesus. Oh, y'all. My legs won't be still. Look at me. Woo, Jesus.
We get up again. We going to get up again and just finish. But I want you to tell the listening audience, Paulette, you know, through your desire to empower people and just impact lives, just being a mighty woman of God that you are, why do you love the Lord so much? And what has He done for you lately?
Let me tell y'all why I really, 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 really love the Lord. I was introduced to God at an early age. I told y'all I had a praying grandmother. Mm-hmm. And I would go to church. My mom and dad did not make us go to church. They gave us an option. And my mother was a choir director, and I always wanted to go to church. I always wanted to be in church. And the first verse I ever learned was, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son. And in that, I realized as I got older, not at 10, but as I got older, that God that I was up on the wall, because they had it up on the wall, I could call on Him. In my very time of trouble, I could really call on Him. I could say something to Him, and He would send somebody. And it was almost like instantaneous at some time, you know, some points in my life. Mm. So I was able to understand that God was real. And then I started going, I got to be 18. I left home, and I got married to this guy I was talking about. And I love God. He knew who God was. He knew the Bible better than anybody I ever met in my life. Still to this day, he can look at the Bible and almost tell you what page of scripture was on. But he really did know God. He just had been tricked by the enemy. And then I started to really, really understand. If I call on the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Come on.
In my time of trouble.
Yeah, that little coach.
He would show up. When I was hurting and I was in the corner crying, I could say Jesus. And my heart would no longer hurt. When I was was out of job and didn't know where my kids were going to get the next meal from. I could say the name Jesus, and the food would literally knock on the door. My sister would come with bags of groceries, and she didn't know I needed groceries. But I told you I had that praying grandmother. She said, Mama would call and say, you need to go take Paulette and them kids some groceries. She said she would get up and come take us groceries. Yeah. But I know the power of praying. I know the power of prayer. And I know the power of Jesus. I know that if I call upon the name of Jesus, see, the word tells me if I call upon the name of Jesus, I can be saved.
Man.
But I also know if I call upon the name of Jesus, he is my very present help. He has never left me. He's never forsaken me. I told you, I got 14 kids. People have 3 kids. 2 of them be sick. I don't have sick kids. I don't have to visit the hospital. That's Ooh. How I know that Jesus is real. See, I don't have the problems that other people have. And I'm not saying because I'm better than him. I understand the power of calling on the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
I understand. When I'm in trouble, I can say, Jesus. I understand that the blood that covers me.
You gonna make me hold my mule here in a minute now. Come on.
That is how come. I know. Oh my God. I had a praying sister named Brenda. She just passed away. But when Brenda, and she didn't teach me nothing. She said, God said, put me in remembrance of his word. She said, what you need? We used to call each other sister. And whatever we needed, earnestly seek him. He just shows up. So that is why I have a desire to talk about Jesus. I love Jesus. And I think people, I may be going away from the question, but people are hurting in this day and time. And I know that the only real escape is Jesus.
Hallelujah.
See, he will cover you from the coronavirus. He will rescue you. Jehovah Jireh will be your
friend.
Yes. I understand those things. And I just believe that if I stand on this porch and I decree and declare some things, if I speak life into somebody's life, then somebody Come will on. Trust God. Somebody will believe in God. You know, sometimes, and I always laugh, I'm like, Lord, why am I dancing on this porch? And then I realized I'm dancing on this porch because just like you were scrolling on Facebook, but see, you know who Jesus is.
Come on, Paulette.
That person that don't know who Jesus is, but they see me dancing around, they're like, what's she doing? And before they know it,
come on, listen to this.
But they don't even know they dancing. Holy Ghost.
It's like thunder. Shut up in your room.
Now they caught on and they jumping around talking about Jesus. So I do know who Jesus is, and I know the power of what he can do.
Amen.
Okay, I'm sorry. Y'all got to forgive me. I get excited. I'm trying to be in the chair. I'm trying to be studious. I'm trying to be on the lens of faith. I'm trying to get to, I want you to invite me back.
Listen to this, Paulette. Listen to this.
That ain't no sad season. Oh, my mule. You better turn that up, girl. That's my husband's song. He's the favorite song. We would drive from Pomona to LA, and he would play that song about 10 times. Oh, Jesus. Y'all gotta listen to the words of this one. That's my praying pack right there. That's a Paulette song. Y'all know that is.
So Paulette, I want want you to talk to us about that David spirit that you got now. Come on now, tell it. Tell us about that David spirit.
I don't know where I got this dance until I almost lose my clothes from. But that is just who I am. It's who I've always been. You would think
I'm the girl that was raised up hanging out in the club, hanging out at all the parties. That wasn't me. All I wanted to be in this life was a mother. Oh, my God. I just wanted to be a mother. Lord, please, please let me be a mother. And that's all I wanted to be, was somebody's mother. But my oldest son, I think at the time he might have been 6, and I taught him how to cha-cha. He's been my cha-cha partner ever since. He's 37. I just have it. I just want to dance. I just want to praise God. I just want to run around. I don't know where it comes from. It's just in me. It's like fire shut up in my bones. That's all I can tell you. I can't make up no philosophical answer. The truth is, it's just who I am. And I kid you not, if you watch me, you'll just see I can't help myself. My son, my baby's 21, I think. He said, "Mama, you on the porch dancing for an hour?" He said, "The whole hour." I said, "Baby, Mama can't even sit down. I don't even want to sit down. I can't help myself. It's just who I am. It's just who I am. It's just who I am."
Hallelujah. Well, I love it.
It's just who I am.
Anxious, because I was getting my hair done one day, and my beautician, she was like, "Who's that lady?" And we talked you up. I was like, "Look, she curling my hair. We going in with you on the line." And I'm like, "Oh my God." She like, tag me in her video. I need some of that, what she got. And we've been watching you. You know, I've been watching you for quite some time now. And I said, you know, that I had to make it my business to reach out to you and you know, get you on the show so that you can bless the masses. And, you know, this show right here is also going to go out to All Nations Radio on Saturday, 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So you're going to go out to All Nations, okay, just to let you know that they're going to be listening and tuning in to this broadcast right here on this coming Saturday. So I'll give you the link and everything just in case you want to catch the replay.
I am going to catch it.
Yes. Absolutely. And, you know, God is just truly amazing. I'm so glad that I was scrolling that day. And
I am too.
Yes. So glad. So glad that you were in my path. And, you know, everything happens for a reason. I wholeheartedly believe that it's all about God's timing. You know, that Kairos timing. It's all about God's timing. When we're supposed to meet people, to impact people, when we're supposed to bless people. So it's all about the timing. I absolutely believe that. So I thank God for you. I want you to keep doing what you're doing. And I'm going to play this last song. So just take over the screen. I'm going to minimize myself so that you do what you do. Okay?
Well, look, let me. Y'all, I ain't got no shoes on. I done took my shoes off.
Amen. And the song is Second Wind, okay? Back here.
Okay, play it for me.
All right, here we go.
I love you so much, and thank you so much for inviting me on your show. Oh, I'm so grateful, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, for choosing me. Oh, I can't hear nothing, Father. Can you see me? Because I got so much sun over here.
Can you hear it, Paulette?
No, I can't.
You can't hear it?
Not well. I hear talking, but I don't hear any music.
Okay. It's playing too. Let's see. Hold on a second.
Thank you, Jesus.
Can you hear this?
Now I can hear really good. Yes. Not worry, not doubt. Yes, God. Oh, hallelujah, Lord. Thank you.
Hey, I love Father.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Show, but I want you to leave the listening audience with three powerful words of encouragement.
They all the same word: love, love, and love. For Jesus so loved the world that he gave. Love conquers all. Love covers a multitude of sin. Love. Love ye one another. Love. Love is such an important thing. It's a thing we take for granted. And I think it heals, and it really heals. A real hug will heal a soul. And I know this because I was a foster mom too. And a real hug will heal a soul. So stop, y'all, and love on one another. Don't allow the pandemic to be angry over the pandemic. Love the people that are in your life. Encourage the people that are in your life. But love, I'm telling y'all, love is the greatest, greatest gift of all.
Hallelujah.
Love.
Hallelujah.
Love, love,
well,
love.
Well, I'm going to ask you to pray us out, Miss Paulette.
Yes, ma'am.
I need you to send me your Cash App or your PayPal so I can deliver the seed to you.
Oh, yes, ma'am. But let's pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you so much for the opportunity and the privilege to be on Lens of Faith today, Father God. Father God, I thank you that this broadcast will reach the masses, not because I'm here, Lord. In the future, her broadcast will reach far and wide, Father God, that it will go to where you send it. It will heal souls. It will mend hearts, Father God. And Father God, I want you to bless Chandra abundantly, Father. I want you to open the windows of heaven, blessings, and pour out a blessing that she will not have enough room to receive, Father God. And Father God, I thank you for every listener. I thank you for every Father God, that will be saved, Father. Oh, Lord, I just thank you. I just thank you for the blood that covers. I thank you because the word says that we call upon the name of Jesus, we will be saved. So, Father God, I just ask that those who have not known Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior, that they have to believe that he died and that he rose, and that they can say with their mouths that they will confess that Jesus is Lord, that they will be saved. So, Father God, we just thank you for that. I thank you so much for being the Lord and Savior of our lives, Father God. And Lord, I just submit my will to you. So, Father, if I've done or said anything that would not allow you to hear my prayers, I ask that you forgive me of my sins right now in the name of Jesus. That you bless, Father God. That you heal the listeners, Father God. That you make them whole, Father God. That they will not lean to their own understanding, but they will acknowledge you in all their ways. And, Lord, you will direct their path. Father, when they get discouraged, they will look to the hill from which cometh their help, because their help comes from you. So, Lord, I thank you again for waking us up this morning, for giving us a sound mind, the ability to see and hear. So, Father God, I thank you. I bless your name in your son Jesus' name. Amen And amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Glory be to the Most High God.
Amen.
God, I give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. God bless you all, listening audience, for tuning in with us on tonight. I pray that the show bless you in one way, shape, or form. Paulette is phenomenal. I want you all to catch her live on that Praise Porch. She is the business, okay?
Thank you. To God be the glory. That's all I'm
going to say. I love you, Miss Paulette. I'll be in touch.
I love you.
Inbox me on how to send that seed to you.
I will. I love you guys.
All right.
Love you, Thank you so much for choosing me.
Yes. Have a blessed
day. Bye-bye.